Hey everybody, it's John with Freshwater Systems, and in our series of answering frequently asked questions, today we're talking about ice and the best way to filter it. Why should you use a filter for your ice machine? Well, as you can guess, if the water is bad, if the water tastes bad, smells bad, or has stuff in it, well, that's what your ice is going to look like. So that's why it's very important to filter the water that's going to make your ice. How does ice filtration work? Well, ice filtration is processing the water that's feeding the ice machine and getting rid of chlorine, getting rid of particulate, and getting rid of things that's going to make the ice cloudy or not look very good. Even with hardness on it, it can have dust on the top of it. So ice filtration is that big term used to process the water to make good ice. Why do you need scale control for your ice filtration? Well, hardness, which is what creates scale, will cause a problem in the formation of ice. As the water freezes, that hardness mineral is going to come out of solution and actually create scale right on the ice cube. Not to mention, the inner workings of the ice machine are going to suffer greatly from that formation of scale internally, and it could wreck the equipment. So it's very important that your ice machine, if you have hard water, is you have some level of scale control, whether you use a water softener or you use some type of phosphate or scale control cartridge. How do you install an ice maker or an ice machine water filter? Well, every ice machine or ice maker, even if we're talking about the one in your house, in your refrigerator, it's fed with a water line. And you just break that water line and connect your filter in there. If you're talking about a commercial ice machine, obviously we're going to need a larger filter, and it might be quite a plumbing project. But a simple ice machine that's in your refrigerator, that's a simple connection of a filter in the line that feeds your refrigerator. What are the advantages of using a filter for an ice machine? Well, it's simple. You're going to get the water to be clearer, the water's going to taste and smell better, and that's all going to result in better ice. How often should you change the filter on your ice machine? That's a great question. And often, it's not changed frequently enough. Most of the time, we are filtering ice machines with carbon. We're dechlorinating or we're getting out chloramines. And if we don't change the filter frequently enough, it actually could make the water worse, resulting in worse ice. So it's very important that we keep up with changing those filters. Carbon filters on a high volume ice machine like this one, they might be in need of a filter change every 6 months. The one at your house, that's probably an annual change out. And rule of thumb is don't let a carbon stay in the water for longer than a year. Always change it out at a year or less. What do ice filters get out of the water? Well, most of the time we're trying to get chlorine out because that has a taste problem. And we're trying to get out particulate and any kind of sediment that is going to get into the ice. And if you've ever had a glass of water and the ice melts a little bit and you've got these things in the water, little floaties, stuff laying on the bottom, that's not good. So the key things is chlorine, taste, odors, and sediment. If we have hardness in the water, then we're going to want to use a scale control. And that scale control is typically a phosphate that holds the hardness minerals in solution so they won't come out in the ice and it won't cause a problem with the mechanics of the machine. So that's pretty much the main things: chlorine, taste, odor, sediment, and scale control. What's the ice wand and what does it do? Well, the ice wand is an antimicrobial stick, if you will. And for ice machines that have a reservoir, it goes a long way to inhibit the formation of slime. In commercial ice machines specifically, slime is a problem. It just grows because airborne bacteria gets in that reservoir. The ice wand is a specific proprietary blend of material that inhibits any kind of bacterial growth. And the scale stick just drops into that reservoir and it keeps slime from growing. Now, I will tell you, you've got to clean the reservoir and the ice machine really well before you put the ice wand in. But once you do that, that ice wand to work like a charm. And it probably needs to be swapped out about every 3-4 months. How does the ice wand make the filtration more efficient for the ice machine? Well, frankly, it doesn't. The ice wand's function is to inhibit the growth of slime or bacteria. It's not really going to help the filtration process, but it's going to keep the slime from becoming part of the water supply feeding the ice machine, which eventually can affect the taste of the ice. So they work independently, doing different things, but the end result is better ice. Well, that's all I got. Be sure and like this video, subscribe to our channel, and check us out on our website, freshwatersystems.com.